Sights and Sounds of Historic Berks on BCTV is supported by the Berks Heritage Council.
Good evening and welcome to Sights and Sounds of Historic Berks County. I'm your host, Amanda Machik, and tonight I'm joined by Heather Hcks from the Daniel Boone Homestead and Carol Adams from the Reading Railroad Heritage Museum. So thank you both so much for joining me tonight. We're doing the virtual thing still. So Heather, I believe, is at home, but Carol's actually at the Reading Railroad Heritage Museum, I believe. Is that correct, Carol?
It is. It's so great to be in person with you. It's the first time on Berks television that we've been able to broadcast from here. So yeah, I'm looking forward to showing you something.
Pretty much. I believe you were going to take us on a little bit of a tour of the exhibit. Are you ready to go or should we start with Heather?
No, I'm ready to go, but I'd like to talk a little bit first about what we are.
Yeah, and for sure. So I know you guys are in Hamburg, but yeah, tell us some more about the museum.
Well, the Reading Railroad Heritage Museum is the educational center for the extensive collections of the Reading Company Technical and Historical Society. And we have so much to do here, and we're so glad to be open again at last after 15 months of closure. We are open again on Saturdays only from 10 to 4. So we're inviting everybody to come on up and see us. We have an absolutely marvelous exhibit, and I'm going to show you a little bit of it, but I hope you don't get dizzy. This exhibit is called The Unseen Engineers of the Reading. Now, usually when you think of a railroad engineer, you're thinking of the person who operates the railroad locomotive. But in this case, we're talking about the engineering department of the Reading. The Reading Railroad had an engineering department that was in-house. They didn't have to contract out for the services of an engineering firm. And so our exhibit here shows something about the Reading Railroad engineering department. And this is our entry display here. We are privileged to have over 30 reproductions of maps and drawings that are located in our archives. And this particular map that I'm showing you now is of this area where the museum now stands from 1864. Now, the thing that is amazing to me is that in 1864, they could draw this map and it's accurate without the help of GPS. They were able to survey it without any technical equipment that's available to surveyors today. I also like this map because it's in color. So when we go into this is the exhibit that keeps changing yearly. And because we were closed, this one is extended until through this October. So you still have time to come up and see it. And it focuses on several different trades. First is surveying, and we have some of our own artifacts here. Some of the transits, some of the surveying books. Those are very interesting. And of course, the tripods. And then we go over here to bridges. It's amazing to see how much detail is put into these maps down to the inch, which of course is very important to know exactly how and exactly the measurements of a bridge. But the exhibit also includes some models. And this model shows the Falls Bridge in Philadelphia, a model by one of our members, plus the drawing from which the bridge was built, and a photograph of a train on that bridge. So this you're going to want to come and spend some time observing, because it's really a beautiful display. And we also talk about drafting and have some drafting tools that are in our collection, some furniture that was in the drafting office. This display on blueprinting. Blueprinting is also not used anymore because of the hazardous chemicals that it involves. But back then, it's what they had in order to copy the drawings. And then we go on to maps. Am I pointing the right?
Yeah, I'm seeing them, I think.
Every quarter mile of the river. What's that? What were you saying, Amanda?
Nothing. It was just getting a little bit choppy, but that's it.
Okay. If I hold still, it helps. Every quarter mile of the railroad had its own map. So we're building the track, knew exactly what you do. Of course, stations is something that everybody loves. Pardon me while I walk here. Many of the viewers know of Frank Furness, very famous architect of the time around the turn of the 1900 century. And here we have one of his original maps. This is not a copy. This is an original. Then we also have some models that display what we're talking about. So you can tell that there are many things that that you can spend time on here. Now, besides the changing display, we also have our regular display that includes model trains of all sizes and other exhibits. So everybody, come on up and see those. Now, in addition to all of that, we have 70 pieces of real trains in the yard behind the museum here. Locomotives and freight cars and passenger cars of all sorts. As you might expect, we do have some events coming up. And the first event that I want to talk about is this one, the Modelers Meet, which is in middle of September. If any of your viewers are model train enthusiasts or just enjoy them, even if they don't have any themselves, you'll want to come out to the Modelers Meet. And that's you can obtain this flyer online by going to our website, readingrailroad.org. Very easy to remember. And we're also very excited that this fall we're going to have some programming for elementary age children. You know that STEAM is very important in education these days, science, technology, engineering, art, and math. And what better place to learn technology than in a technology museum?
Yeah.
Now the plans aren't finalized yet, but when if you watch the website, you will see them real soon.
And then,
now you might think that while we were shut down, nothing happened, but that would be wrong. Finally, we have during COVID time, finished the construction of our rail car protection building. And this building is 70 feet by 150 feet. And it will have four tracks in it that we can protect some of our valuable equipment. You know, once we've got it all painted up and pretty, we sure don't want the weather to damage it right away. So we're real excited about that.
I remember you talking about that a while ago. So when you first started on the project.
It took us a long time to get the funding together and but now it's ready now. Well, not quite ready. We still have to put track in it and that will cost some more. So if any of the viewers want to help out with that, that's also possible to donate at our website. There's also membership information there. And we just never have enough members. all the members are welcome. And you probably remember too, Amanda, that we're entirely a volunteer group. We have no yes. paid staff at all.
Yes, I do remember that a bit. Well, Carol, I think it's just about time that we switch on over to Heather, but did you have any last minute things you'd like to add? I know you did talk about the membership and the volunteers.
Let's just say that we're open again on Saturday. Okay. Saturday's okay. from 10 to 4. So we hope to see everybody with us.
Yeah, excellent, excellent. All right, well, thank you so much. It's always
thank
great
you for
to have
time.
To have you on the show, and it was cool to see the new exhibit. And how remind me again, how often do you typically change that?
We usually have an exhibit that's different every year between March and October. It usually runs from March to October.
Okay.
So this
okay.
one was prepared for 2020, but we couldn't open, obviously.
That's right. Okay. And because you typically are closed January, February, right?
Yes, half of January and all of February is a typically closed time.
Okay. So then the new exhibit runs March to October. Okay, cool. Mm-hmm. All right. Well, thank you again.
So
all right, Heather, how are you tonight?
Good. Thank you for having us on.
Yeah. So Heather is from the Daniel Boone Homestead, frequent guest of the show, but there's some, I guess, exciting news about, much like Carol was talking about with the Reading Railroad Heritage Museum being closed. The homestead was also closed, I don't know, was it 15 months?
It was about that. We closed March 15th. And
you opened April. So,
April.
Yeah. So I guess maybe 13 months. Yeah, but open now, and I guess even more the kind of restrictions are being lifted. So tell us a little bit about what's going on over there.
So, we're offering tours at the homestead. We're only open Fridays, Saturdays, and Sundays, and we have three tours of the Boone House, and those are at 11, 1, and 3 o'clock. So if you're looking for a guided tour of the Boone House, those are the times that we're doing them. Guests can come anytime during those days and self-guided tour. And currently we're doing those free to the public, kind of a way to give back to the community after being closed. And so those will we continue to probably be free to the public to at least September 1st. And so those are some of the events. We're starting off small, but we are currently restarting our rental programs. We're updating our website currently, so hopefully that will be up in the next week. But we are going to be welcoming back organized tent camping for Scout and other youth groups, and for in our north and south picnic area. And then we will be opening the Wayside Lodge for rentals on September 1st as well. So I know that makes a lot of the Boy Scouts and the groups happy.
Yeah.
But currently we've had about almost 1,000 people visit the homesteads, on our 3 days. So it's been a really great reopening for us. I started right before COVID started. So it's really been my opportunity to see the site, functioning as a site.
Yeah.
Which has been great. But we are also, similar to the railroad program, working on some fall programs. Currently, we are working with Exeter Township for their Fall Fest program. I think they had it there a couple of years ago.
2019, I think. Yeah, right before COVID,
Yep, we're bringing it back and it's gonna be better than ever. And so there'll be all sorts of fun events happening on that day. I don't wanna release a date quite yet. We have a meeting scheduled later this week but you should definitely keep your eye out for more of those, that kind of events. And we're also working on some other things. We've been speaking with some people about doing some lecture series, and we're hoping to do a junior bird watching program. We have, yeah, we've got an amazing array of birds and wildlife at the site. So I think that that'll be a great opportunity to highlight something that we normally don't always show off, the park.
Yeah. Part.
We've got close to 600 acres. But, and of course, we're working on some holiday programs as well. So if anyone is interested in keeping an eye on our programs, they can go to our website, which is thedanielboonehomestead.org. I didn't make a sign, so I'll just have to say it. So thedanielboonehomestead.org. But we also have Facebook, we're on Instagram, and so we'll be updating on social media, sending out email blasts to all of our you know, followers. So there's plenty of ways to keep, you know, up with the latest on what's happening at the homestead. And while we were closed, we of course worked on a whole slew of improvements to the property. And we're continuing to do improvements to the property. We are going to be getting a new exhibit, hopefully this September, in our Welcome Center. So currently we have a temporary exhibit in there right now, but there'll be a brand new exhibit that looks at the three families of the homestead and, you know, how they were sort of a microcosm of what was happening in southeastern Pennsylvania. And we're going to be getting a new lighting project that will add some more lights to our parking lots for our evening events. So that'll be great when we have those. And of course, we're also have a lake project coming up that will be starting hopefully next year, which will be dredging the lake to sort of take it back to its 1940s original status, which will also help some of the ecology and, you know, the water systems that we have there. In addition to that, we're also part of the Exeter Master Plan, which is the one thing I sort of wanted to promote at the before my time is up. Our next public meeting is going to be September 27th. And this is a project that we're doing in conjunction with Exeter Township. That is looking at the resources, both the cultural resources, the historic resources, and the natural resources of the park, and looking at ways that we can make them more accessible, more usable, and more community friendly. So if anyone has ideas or thoughts or would like to hear what they've been coming up with, we've been working on this for, how many months have we been working on this for? Several.
I don't know. I don't even remember when it started.
Well, our next public program will be coming up, and that's certainly obviously something you can get information on Exeter's Township's website or my own, but it will be, the next one is September 27th, and it will be a great way to, you know, see they've been, as I said, doing ecology studies and historic studies of the buildings and talking to all sorts of people. They've been doing interviews with the community, and it'll be a great way to, you know, find out some thoughts about the park. And these are really blueprints. From that, what we can do is, you know, see what people are interested in, and then look for funding sources. So not everything that comes out of the master plan necessarily will come to fruition. But what it will do is it will provide, you know, sort of pave the way for us to start making some of those projects a reality. So, you know, things like an expansive trail system and stuff, it'll give you the starting point for those things. So it really is a great thing. And I encourage anyone who's interested in the homestead to definitely get involved in that project. And I guess the last thing I wanted to kind of you know, wrap up with is volunteers. So very much like the railroad, we are predominantly, although not all, volunteer programs. And we are looking for volunteers and people who are interested in the homestead. We've got everything from research to gardening to education to greeters. So we have a lot of different opportunities for people, particularly who are interested in maybe our upcoming events. And they can once again go to our website, thedanielboonehomestead.org. There is a join us button that they can cling to and of course fill out the information and I'll be in touch, or they can always reach out and call us at the homestead. But we'd be delighted to have more people join us and sharing and promoting its history. So it's something we're definitely looking for right now.
So I had wanted to ask Heather, because you were talking earlier about I think a newsletter or kind of a e-blast emails. And I was just curious, can people sign up to receive those on the website? Is there a place? Okay.
Absolutely. If they go to our website, usually it's at the bottom of the page, they can subscribe, and that will keep you, that is probably the best way to keep updated with events and our programs and what's happening at the homestead. So I would encourage people to definitely sign up there. But also, as I said, they can also, you know, follow us on social media. That's another place where we'd be definitely updating information as it comes available.
Okay, cool. And you said there's Facebook and Instagram, right? Both?
Right.
Okay.
So those are predominantly the two social networks that we're using right now.
Okay. Yeah, I know. I see obviously stuff almost every day, I guess, on the Facebook page anyway. So, anything else? I'm trying to think. Anything else you'd like to share? I know you mentioned about the upcoming projects. Did you want to mention any of the previous ones that have been completed? Yeah, I know we kind of talked a lot about those last time, but.
Right. I mean, there's been extensive work at the park. Obviously, we've done some repainting of the barn, the Boone house, and the building.
Yeah.
Which were taken back. The Boone house particularly was returned to its original color. We had done some, paint studies and were able to bring that back. That was really exciting. And it really makes the whole, building pop in a way that I think.
Yeah. Well, I don't know. The whole historic area now, the whole thing, when you look back, it gives it a whole new look. So.
Yep. And of course, we replaced one of our new bridges. That has been complete. Our bathrooms had a significant upgrade while we were closed.
Okay.
Of course, now that those are open, you can enjoy them. And there is we're getting connected to the township sewer lines. So those are some projects that are coming along. we've also got new projects on the horizon as well. So we're really excited that there's a lot happening, at the homestead to sort of upgrade the site.
Well, and fairly recently, there was a new lighting in the visitor center and a new desk, right? I don't know if that was finished the last time you were on.
But I think anyone who comes into our visitor center, as I said, it's sort of an in-between stage, but in September, it will have a whole new upgraded look. And it'll look, it looks really sharp and it looks really, I think it's going to look amazing. And I think people are going to be impressed by its change. Yeah.
Now I know before, when you first reopened, you were selling tickets online. Is that still happening? And is it still recommended that people buy them online? Cause you did mention just 3 tour times, but I guess the tours themselves now are much larger.
Correct. And
tour groups are much larger.
I do recommend, while we have indeed increased our capacity tours, I would indeed recommend doing them online. Accommodate, some walk-in guests, but if you want to avoid disappointment, I would definitely
suggest. Gotcha.
And that can be done through our website very easily.
Okay. And again, you had mentioned that they'll probably be free through September, at least, you thought? Okay, cool. Excellent. All right. Well, I want to thank you both for joining me tonight, Heather and Carol. It's always great to have you guys on the show. And here, it's nice to hear both of these sites after having such a long closure are finally open and thriving again. So that's wonderful. All right. Well, thank you both again. And thanks to our viewers for joining us tonight. And we'll see you next month. Good night.
Good night. Thanks.
Sights and Sounds of Historic Berks on BCTV is supported by the Berks Heritage Council.